Alhamdulillah. You look Muslim. Everyone's Muslim. You Muslim, brother? Christian?
Yes.
You look Christians, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. What is it, Catholic or what is?
Yeah.
Catholic?
Yeah.
Because my wife, she was a Catholic.
Oh, okay.
But she became Muslim.
Okay.
Before I married her, yeah? I didn't force her, you know?
Yeah.
So you look pray to Mary.
Yeah.
So what do you think about, like, when you look to Jesus teaching himself, praying to God?
I
don't want to put you on the spot. But what I would say to you, as a Muslims, we believe in Jesus. We believe he was a great messenger, the true Messiah. We go against the teaching of some Jewish who say that he was a bastard. We say, no, he was a true Messiah. And he was born without a father. However, we believe that people after him, they went too extreme about him, either make him equal to God, because Jesus himself prayed to God alone. So why I'm going to pray to Jesus, it's like me, I'm a Muslim. Prophet Muhammad prayed to God directly. If I pray to Prophet Muhammad, I'm not following Prophet Muhammad. Because Prophet Muhammad prayed to who? To Allah. So if you really want to follow Jesus, you pray to God alone. You understand? And also we know that Jesus' teaching has not been preserved. That's why the language that Jesus spoke, it was Aramaic. We don't have it anymore. We have it in the Greek, the Bible. And we cannot even trace it back. But when it comes to Islam, the Quran, one of the miracles of the Quran, Allah mentioned he will preserve it and people will memorize it. That's why if the Muslims and the Jews and the Christians, all of them decide to burn the scriptures, the only scripture will remain with us in our heart is the Quran. Because around the world, Muslims at the age of 9 and 10 memorize the Quran word for word, letter for letter. It's like, you know, the alphabet. Everyone memorizes A, B, C. By writing it, I can, you know, say A, O, C. I can change it, but I will never be able to change it within the heart. People say, no, Brother Shamsi, you're wrong. It's A, B, C. You understand? That's the beauty of the Quran. We're not in need of the written form because we memorize it. The Muslim children, the age of 9 and 10, and even some Muslims do not even speak the Arabic language and memorize the Quran word for word, letter for letter. And you know what? It's a miracle. You know why? Because imagine all of us here, we memorize a book in Chinese. But guess what? None of us know Chinese. Because, hang on, that doesn't make any sense. You know that book in Chinese and you're pronouncing it correctly, but you don't even speak Chinese. The Quran, there's a beauty of it. Memorized by millions of Muslims. You know, so I would tell you, look, I know you're born in a Christian family, understand that, but God gave us intellect. We cannot just follow our forefathers or our parents, you know. My wife, one of the reasons she became Muslim, she told me, when she was young, she said, it did not make sense to me. I'm praying to Mary, who prayed to God. Or, God, Jesus is God, but he has a God. It makes sense to her. She started searching. She became Muslim way before I met her. And she became Muslim, alhamdulillah. Because Islam goes in line with our sound, isn't it? There's only one God, perfect God. He's not in need of us. Everyone's in need of him. When Allah told us to worship him, not because in need of our worship, because we are in need of worshiping him. It's like, imagine you in a house and there's a fire everywhere. May Allah forbid. And I came to save your life. If you thank me, say, Shamsi, I thank you for saving my life. If I said, listen, don't thank me, say, no, Shamsi, you deserve it. You saved my life. What about the one who gave you life and gave you everything? We should thank him, we should be grateful to him. But how? According to his way. I believe if I was alive at the time of Jesus, the only way to worship God, by following Jesus' teaching. Before Jesus is Moses, now the last prophet is Muhammad. You know, even just look at what's happened in our time. There is a war against our human nature. Literally now, someone can tell, listen, you clearly see me as a man, but I believe I'm an elephant. And you have to accept me. Otherwise, you're a bigot. That's what's happening now. There's a war against our human nature. You know what is crazy? That we have to literally blind follow these ideas. Otherwise, they will call us racist or a bigot or backwards. I mean, I don't mind calling me any name, but I'm not going to become a blind follower. I'm not sheep. I'm not going to deny my own eyes. Understand? And the only religion that is standing against this evil agenda who they want to destroy human nature is Islam. That's why there is a huge war against Islam as well. Not against Christianity. In America, in Australia, Germany, Sweden, days, every day, there's a bad article about Islam. Because they notice people gravitating towards Islam. You understand?
Yes.
You know, make sense? Yeah, so do you have any question about Islam? You can ask, don't worry.
No, I just like listening.
Alhamdulillah. Yeah. So, you know.
From your knowledge.
Yeah.